Hey, Issy here. So this is just the video for you that wanting to install Microsoft Project 2021, in my case, Professional, and you've got a key and you want to be able to install it. So just follow these steps. Now, this is kudos to this guy, I think is Indian, that made this video, but it wasn't in English. And so I struggled through sort of getting all the points down. And so I thought I'd make this video. I'll still reference him in the description, but at least this will help us that can't speak Indian get all the steps correct in the right order. So this is showing that project's working fine. Start date today, finish date tomorrow. Well, actually you can just go 50 days and then it's fine. So I'll shut this down anyway. No. Okay, so first things first, you're gonna go in and you're gonna go to config.office.com. And here, this is where you're gonna config the file that's gonna have your manual key that you've sort of already downloaded. So you click create. You select your architecture, which in my case is 64, and then you come down to project and you select the project professional 2021 license that I've got. And then you just go next. Here, just make sure you choose English, US, because if you select UK, it's for some reason it didn't work very well with my key that I had. Here, next. Now I turned this off, but I guess you could leave this on if I don't think it would really matter. I think it just checks to see if there's anything else on there that you've had in the past. Here's where you'd add in your manual code. So you just click MAK, type in your code. I'll just leave it as this, so then that way we can configure it. You go next, next. And then here you just scroll down outside of that part to finish. And then it's created an XML file that you're going to export and save into a folder. But let's go make that folder now. So I'll bring these windows down. So you need a folder on your desktop is what he did. So we'll just do the same. But it needs to say Project Professional 2021 Setup. And so you type that into this, and then this folder will hold the configuration file that we're about to export into it. I'll delete these two, delete this one, and delete this. So that's gonna go into this folder. Then we're gonna go and create the install.bat file, and we'll use text editor for that. And then we'll download the developer tools, and then all three things together will do magic things. So we'll go back to where we were. We're back into that configuration. We're going to export, accept, just leave it as configuration, and export that file to that folder that you just made up on the desktop. So in my situation, it's on the desktop. It's down here. And then I'm just going to save it into there. I won't save it because we've got one in there. But once it's saved in there, you're done step sort of two, because you've already got the code or the key. So this is step two done. So then step number three, I'll close this down, is we're going to create this text file that's going to be sort of the install.bat or install.bat file that's going to sit in that same folder. So it's step two of the things. And this is what you need to put into it. Setup, but we're going to add just a .xex to this. So we'll copy this. We're going to open up Notepad and we're going to put this in here like that. Now you can just type it in like this, but my spelling's terrible, so this is why I just showed you already here. And then you're going to save that, save as install.bat. You're going to change this to all files. And then you're going to find that same folder, which is going to be for me on the desktop. We'll go back in, just do step by step. And in here we're going to save. Yes. And we're going to save that file to that location. And now, close this down. We've got step two done. So third step is the one that we need to download this deployment tool. So then we're gonna go select English. And I think I had to do this again because here we go. We're gonna download this. And these links will be in the description. And then you're gonna save this to that same folder. But in this situation, I'm just gonna save it to a separate folder because I am conscious that it might not show you all the parts. So we'll just say 2021 setup. Open this. Okay, save. And it should save into there. If I run this, yes. Okay, my bad. So you actually have to save, so you save it to your downloads and then you're gonna run it. And then it's gonna want to extract that into another folder. So in this situation, we should have gone, save it to downloads and then saved it into our folder. But we'll just do it like this. We'll go here. 2021 setup, where is that? Here, okay, file is extracted. So if I just delete this, because this is what you'd see when you save that originally, this is what you'd see when you save it to that folder that we made before. There's a couple of things that we need to delete. So we can just delete these configuration files, delete those, and we're just left with setup.exe. So I go back to our folder that we made. Now you can see we've got three different things. The configuration that we got from that first sort of tab on here. The second thing is going to be the install.bat file that we created using Notepad. And the third thing is the setup.exe. So once you've done that, then what you'll do is you'll just click install and it will run a shell and then it will open up and it should start installing. And once it starts doing that, there might be a few prompts that you need to go through just to click to continue. And don't be stressed out if it's a little bit slow, because it took probably like 10 minutes for me to install this, because I had to download, I guess, all the developer stuff, whatever. And then it downloaded it, installed it. I think I had to restart my computer, and then it was there. It was under projects. I could go in projects, and it was just there. Now, I thought, what happens if I've already got Microsoft Office on here? So if you don't want to know anything more, this is just troubleshooting now, so you can stop the video and go and try it now. But this is a couple of the troubleshooting things that I sort of figured out. And I'll just check my notes, because I sort of made a couple of things here. The US English thing was one thing. The second thing, like, so make sure you're in the configurations, you only use that and not UK. And then because I've already paid the subscription every month for Microsoft Office, I thought, like, that's going to be conflicting, because this key is not necessarily attached to that Microsoft Office 365 or that online version. I thought, well, I'll go and reinstall the Microsoft Office stuff. Now, that's where I'm going with this point with this troubleshooting. Because I had Microsoft Office already installed on this PC, it wanted to run before it installed this dev sort of program that we're talking about, installing that install.bat file. I wanted to sort of take everything off the computer, which I guess makes sense. It wants to remove all this like personal stuff and then apply this sort of professional business stuff, which it just did. Then I reinstalled the Microsoft 365 stuff, and then it just works. It was still fine. So if you do have Microsoft Word, don't stress out. You will be able to put it back on. It'll attach back up to your username, but it will... you'll have to take it off first, install the professional version of what we're trying to put on project, and then re-add on the other stuff, and it should be okay. I guess the way you could get around this is by just buying a key, or buying sort of the software for home office or professional office, whatever. But in this situation, this is something that I found out. Other than that, I hope that helps. I appreciate this other guy's video, and maybe go and just give his video a view and a like, so he gets a bit of a pump up. And any other questions, let me know. All right, see ya. Bye.